are you all enjoying your day so far? Oh, come on, you do better than that, come on. Yeah. That's a little bit better. All right, anyway, my name's Carl, and this is Lucy, and we're going to basically be discussing about cosplay, what it is, and how to sort of initially get into it, and fabrication, props, and rhythm.
It's a hobby, at the end of the day, and you can use anything you want. In this case, for the barrel, didn't know what I was going to do for it, and then sitting there, just eating my pot of fruit, going, oh, I don't know how to do it, and there's something for me. It's circular, it's barrel shaped, so just cut it up, and that's just a Pringle pot there.
And on this cauldron there, on an attachment,
yes,
which are
well,
like a quid in like any DIY store.
Plumbing attachments,
really,
they're a great one as well, so if you like the DIY place and just look at the plumbing sections. Lots of different types of plastic things, weird shapes, randomness, something about broke, I don't know. Just, you know, the child's cauldron sits in the zone like that, it's like looking all moody. But, yes.
And this is like a miniature cupboard door handle. It looks kind of obvious, which, because I didn't have time to make it into something else, but you could like stick sculpting on the end to make it like pointy, or you could sound it, so it's like oval. This is the same structure as the gun blade, it's just one bit of wood all the way through, sanded, feathered and painted. Feathering is a really key thing to get your prop smooth, no matter what it is. You've got to make it look smooth, because if you can see the tape, if you can see like the wood grain and it's supposed to be metal, it's not going to look professional. This was done on a lathe. I luckily had access to a lathe, you know, the spinny thing at my college, which was awesome because I wanted a perfect dome. And it was just like, this is not the original, it was like a disc of wood with a load of blue solid foam. Yeah, it was like a really tough solid foam, and then I put it on the lathe and spun it and chiseled it so it came a dome. I grooved in these bits and then I moulded it with silicone, like, so you put the mould like that and then you just pour silicone over it, thick silicone, so that it kind of just sets like a centimetre over the top of the coat. And then you do fiberglass layer, quite thick. And then when it's all set, you take it off and you have like a bowl with it like indented in.
Please be kind to me, okay? It's been a very long day. Okay, so everybody who has been taking part in this workshop will know where to start. You start with a circle. Okay, so when you look at someone, the width of the eye is about the rough same size of the space in between, so I'm just going to mark that out. So above the eyes, for another line, that was where it will be sitting. And for those people who have actually been taking part in the workshop and actually remember this. Okay, now to the hair. Above the circle that you've drawn, where the face of the skull would be, go a little bit above for the hair. And if we were going to draw a fringe, going straight across, we gently draw a line straight across as a guide, and roughly near the parting of the hair, draw a line coming down. Just be confident with the lines. Quite often people would kind of take their time and kind of dot the line together and it will end up looking really furry, so try not to do that. If you're going to make a line, just go man mode and just go for it. It doesn't matter if it goes wrong. The thing about drawing is that it takes a lot of patience to learn, and you just have to keep on going and doing the same thing over and over again until you become really, really good. Great, now for the line up. Same as before, just be confident with the lines. Start with the eyes. People first. Quite often anime and manga, they put a lot of attention onto the eyes, so try to use a lot of detail here. With the same color pen, if you make lines, you can create a sense of shadow. The nose, the mouth, and with this pen is a special brush marker, so it depends on the pressure you put. So the harder you push, the thicker the line will be, and the more gentle you are, the thinner the line. You can see this?
Thank you. My name is Bonnie.
Who are you cosplaying?
I'm cosplaying Weasel, who is a Pokemon.
Woo! Tell me a bit about your character and also your costume.
Well, Weasel is my favourite Pokemon, and I thought if I come as a Pokemon character, everyone's going to expect me to be Ash or Pikachu. So I thought, do something different. My costume, I made all myself with the help of my parentals. And it was absolute murder on the tail. We had a little tantrum at the sewing machine halfway through.
I've been there.
It was, in the end, it was worth it. So,
it's brilliant, it's amazing. Give it back. The microphone doesn't pick up through Mars, sorry. Hi!
Hello there.
What's your name?
My name's Leo.
Tell me a bit about your costume. Who are you cosplaying?
It's an original character that's actually inspired from a comic I read in Japan. As far as I'm translating, it's called Battle Titan Pushka.
And tell me a bit about your costume.
I basically collected a load of parts, toy guns, shields, bike body armour, American football armour, even a bit of a treasure pipe, and just basically added and retrofitted every piece of stuff I can find to make a large, sort of complete costume.
Is it hard to wear?
It's alright.
Well, give it back, it's amazing. Hello. What's your name?
Aurora.
And what's your character?
Emma I. Helga.
Hi.
Hi.
What's your name?
Lola.
And what's your costume?
CL Phantom Heim.
You're wonderful. Take him out. What's your name?
Grace.
What's your character and tell me about your costume?
It's Edward Elric from Full Metal Alchemist, and I bought the rest of it, but I made the hand.
Wow, that's really cool. Well, let me see that move. Show the guys that your hand.
There you go.
That's wonderful. Can you pick things up with it? Oh, that's it's articulated. That's really good. Okay, give it back. What's your character?
Claire, my own character.
Tell me a bit about your character and a bit about your costume.
She's a kind of wolf cat dragon combo thing. And my mum spent ages on it.
Oh really? Did she make it all? That's amazing. What's your name?
I'm Louisa.
Tell me a bit about your character and your costume.
Well, the character is Momiji Inugarashi from the Tohu Project. She's a wolf demon.
And tell me about your costume.
I pretty much made it myself with a bit of help from mum.
It looks amazing. I like your little... So that's a good touch. Okay, give a bow. And your shoes are very hard to walk in now.
Russia from Italia.
Do you want to give it back?
dress. Tell me a bit about your character and your costume.
I'm Sebastian Michaelis from Black Butler.
The little details as well, it's really cool. Do you want to go back? I'm bowing for everyone. Hi.
Hi.
What's your name?
My name's, everyone knows me in Fastly, actually.
And what's your character?
A really good one from Blue Exorcist.
Okay, well, do you want to give a little bow as well?
Sophie.
Oh wow, that's brilliant. who are you cosplaying?
I'm Yuki from Vampire Knight.
I'm Rain Kagamine from Vocaloid.
Do you want to go with Pal? Okay, what's everyone's name?
Holly.
Katie.
Libby.
Hannah.
And you're obviously deaf now. Who's everyone's character, in case anyone doesn't know?
Misa.
Mello.
Max.
Ryu.
But then let's give a big bow. Okay, so first up, I'm going to announce our single
I think, yeah, single cosplay winner. And to tell you why and who won, it is lovely.
Hello. We chose this girl because we really liked how much effort she put into her costume, and it was all hand sewn, and it was all really neat and detailed, and we just loved the effort and time she put into it. So the winner for the solo category is Claire.
Congratulations, we loved how much effort you put in when you told us it took months, and it's so well made. We honestly didn't know you'd made it until you told us, so that's such a good job. If you could give a big clap walk down there, a big round of applause. Congratulations. Okay, now
you've got the better mic.
I'm stealing your mic. Now we're to Carl. This is our group cosplay winner. And who is it?
Well, it's an anime I keep hearing a lot about, and I'm meaning to go watch at some point. But we decided that the best for the groups is Attack on Titan!
Apart from tiny little pants, poor thing.
Okay, so, let's go up.
ground with the last survivors, but thank you everyone so much for this weekend. It's been just the best time ever. So thank you so much. A big round of applause for Victoria.